From September 8 to 28, 2013, Zamboanga City was a virtual urban war zone. Gunfire, troop movements, civilians moving out of their homes. In the late hours of September 8, soldiers encountered hundreds of armed men in the Rio Hondo district. The next day, a contingent of the Moro National Liberation Front under Javier Malik entered the city. Malik, who is loyal to MNLF founding chairman Nur Misuari, stormed into the city in an attempt to raise their flag in City Hall. Aside from Rio Hondo, the armed men occupied the villages of Santa Catalina, Santa Barbara, and Talon Talon. Over 200 hostages were taken, mostly civilians. Authorities closed the airport and curfew was imposed. The question on people's minds, where is Misuari? A spokesperson said he was on the ground in Zamboanga City, but City Mayor Beng Climaco claimed she talked to Misuari and disavowed the attack on her city. As the days dragged on, the evacuees increased, the number reaching 118,000 residents. They had no recourse but wait for the conflict to end. When it finally did, the siege left 200 dead, including cops, soldiers, rebels, and civilians. Hundreds more were wounded. Hundreds of MNLF fighters were also arrested. A total of 10,000 homes were burned to the ground. Some 200 residents taken hostage by the MNLF were released and traumatized. Total damage was estimated at more than $73 million. The September 2013 MNLF attack is reminiscent of a similar assault in Zamboanga City in November 2001. Some 300 breakaway MNLF members, led by Misuari's nephew, Haji Julhambri, took hostage about 100 people in Kabangtangan complex. The hostages were eventually released after negotiations. 3 years after the Zamboanga siege, nearly 14,000 people still live in temporary shelters. Misuari and his followers were charged for alleged violation of humanitarian law and other crimes. Misuari then went into hiding. The decision of a passing court to temporarily suspend the arrest warrant against Misuari in connection with the Zamboanga City siege has been received warmly by Misuari's camp.
The time we are communicating with Secretary Dorisa, and of course we are made aware of the efforts of the government to lift the warrant of arrest. And we are very, very thankful that these things had been done by the government. We do not see that there would be some problem on the peace process. If you notice, the chairman and the president are very, very close friends. And if you would factor in that element, then you would realize then that there is no possibility that they can disagree.
City Hall is open.
Meanwhile, Zamboanga City Mayor Beng Climaco says while she supports government's peace efforts, she will pursue the cases against Misuari and his men.
We are very hopeful that justice will be served. The pain can never be fully healed because the suffering of the people still continues. On the part of the city government, what we're really expecting is that on the part of the Department of Justice, that they will be able to continue on holding accountable those that are responsible.
Hours after the temporary suspension of his arrest warrant, Misuari was welcomed by Duterte in Malacañang. In a break from protocol, the president allowed Misuari to use the presidential podium for a speech aired live on national TV.